Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. There was a tweet posted by Jeff Faust about the next Starlink mission. He said, at Satellite 2021, SpaceX CFO Brett Johnson says the first Starlink polar launch is coming up in the next couple of days. In relation to that tweet, I wanted to share the launch information for the next Starlink launch. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch is actually Monday 13th, so by a couple of days I guess he meant a few more days. There were also further tweets from Jeff Faust with information from Brett Johnson. This one says, we are producing 5,000 Starlink dishes a week and will have multiples of that in coming months. New lower cost unit coming out later this fall. Then, in another tweet, he said, Johnson on SpaceX's acquisition of Swarm Technologies found a company that had interesting IP and a team we can leverage. We have not done acquisitions in the past, but would consider something in future if it met right requirements. There was also another which said, we think Starlink will look and feel like a public company in a few years, will be easy for people to understand the business model and cash flows will be predictable. For those who don't know, Netflix have created a limited series of the Inspiration 4 mission called Countdown Mission to Space. They posted this tweet about it. They said, on September 6th you'll meet the 4 civilians going into space. On September 13th you'll see them prepare. On September 15th you'll watch the live launch. On September 30th you'll be in space alongside them. Countdown Inspiration 4 Mission to Space takes off next week. On the talk of crewed missions, Michael Sheets posted a couple of tweets. The first says, NASA and SpaceX are targeting April 15, 2022 for the launch of the Crew 4 mission. Crew 4 will carry NASA astronauts Shel Lindgren and Bob Hines, ESA astronaut Samantha Cristoforetti, and a fourth crew member yet to be named. Then, in response to that, he also posted SpaceX and NASA crew rotation schedule, Crew 3 launch October 31st. Crew 2 return November 1st to November 15th. Crew 4 launch April 15th. Crew 3 return April 22nd to April 30th. You'll likely know about the Amazon and Starlink Gen 2 fiasco in which we saw a response from SpaceX last episode. Michael Sheets posted a tweet saying, Amazon fires back in a dispute over the Starlink Gen 2 amendment request to the FCC. The conduct of SpaceX and other Musk-led companies makes their view plain, rules are for other people. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a great view of the launch site. The Mechazilla catching arms or chopsticks are continuing construction. Foundation work continues at the production site for the new wider high bay. There was this article posted which says, environmental campaigners have issued several warnings about the SpaceX launch site in South Texas which reportedly threatens the surrounding landscape and wildlife. I don't know too much about this but will add that Kennedy Space Center is a thriving wildlife refuge. The upper stack for the ground support equipment tank GSE-8 was stacked in the mid bay. As we saw last episode, these 3 Raptor engines were transported to the launch site for Ship 20 installation. Then, the Raptors were also installed underneath Starship as they prepare for testing. Crews continue to work on replacing the Starship 20 thermal protection tiles. The tiles are looking very close to completion. Work on Booster 4 has continued recently inside the high bay. Then, yesterday, the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype once again rolled out to the launch site with the 29 Raptors installed. Chris Burgin has also posted a tweet today of the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype being put back on the orbital launch mount. To finish today's video, I have to say thanks to Stephen Marr for filming some of the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to Nick Ansuini who has also been out filming the Boca Chica content as well. Then, as always, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, livestreams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.